Here's the development of the rule for which values of p make the integral from a to infinity of 1 over x to the p converge. So we're considering this improper integral, and we're trying to find out what values of p make it converge or diverge. And we'll need that because we're going to compare integrals later on, and we needed to know this one well. So here's your pictures. For example, if p is less than 1, like 0.5, 1 over x to the 0.5, the curve, it dives down to 0 because, you know, x is going to infinity. But does it dive down fast enough to prevent this area adding up to infinity? Here's another example. Here's with p equal to 2. That's greater than 1. And x squared is a big number, and as x goes to infinity, maybe this area squashes down, you know, because of the curve is diving to 0 fast, maybe that converges. And then over 1 over x, well, you don't know what's going to happen there. You know, it's kind of in between those two. Okay, so let's just see what happens. Okay, so we're just going to go from a to infinity of your integrand in there, which is defined as limit of b goes to infinity of a to b of 1 over x to p dx. So considering just this part, you rewrite 1 over x to p as x to negative p and do the integration, work it all out, and you get this. Okay, so then you say, okay, I needed the limit as b went to infinity. And so now you have to think about that. Okay, so p, we're in the case of case 1, p less than 1. So here's our general expression for what went on. And then here's our cases. If p is less than 1, then 1 minus p is definitely positive. That's a plus number, because p is less than 1. If p is less than 1, then this is just going to be b to something like 0.5, 0.8. If p is less than 1, you're just going to have a positive number up there. And as b goes to infinity, with this positive number being there, positive exponent, then it's going to go to infinity. And this here is just some number. So the whole limit is going to go to infinity, which means it does not exist. The integral diverges. Case 2, p equal 1. Okay, so we're going to just treat that a little different. For p equal 1 case, that's a 1. So you just get this integral here. And we know that integral. Integral from a to b of 1 over x is log absolute value of x. Of course, a is greater than 0, and all these numbers on this interval are greater than 0. So it's just log of x. And that evaluates out to log b minus log a. And that's just going to be mean that the limit as b goes to infinity, log of b is going to be moving to infinity slowly, but it's going to go to infinity slow. This is just a number, so that's not going to affect it. So again, the answer is goes to infinity. That actually does not exist. and the integral of 1 over x, in that case, diverges. Case 3, p greater than 1. So again, we have this, there's your integral, there's your limit definition. As in case 1, the expression comes out like this. Okay, so then you have to just reason this out. If p is greater than 1, then this here is a negative number. This here is also negative. So that's a b to a negative exponent. That means it's 1 over b to a positive exponent. Plus. So that is going to go to 0 as b goes to infinity. And again, this number here, it's just a number. So the expression is going to go to here. And it's going to be equal to negative a to the 1 minus p over 1 minus p. So not only do we know it converges, because a is just a number, it also converges to that value. So the integral converges, that's for sure, and the integral converges to this value when p is greater than 1. So here's an example. For p less than 1, like 0.8, here's your function here. It doesn't look like it's diving fast enough to 0. In other words, since 0.8 is less than 1, the exponent on the x is too low, too small, for the values of 1 over x to the 0.8 to dive to 0 fast enough so the area converge. Another way of saying that is f of x dives to 0 too slowly. Too much area adds up. The integral diverges. So see this? Because this curve takes too much time converging down to 0, there's too much area under it that's adding up as you go to infinity. That's what makes the integral diverge. Here's the case of p greater than 1. Okay, such as 1.5. So, looking at the picture, looks like this area is crammed down against the x-axis because the curve is diving to 0 faster because of the exponent on the x in the denominator. So f of x dives to 0 fast enough to limit the area from adding up too much. So the integral converges, and as we saw, it converges to this. So in this example, with the a equaling a 2, we can actually just put the numbers in. The p was 1.5. Get this expression and figure out that it adds up to square root of 2. Alright, so I put this into the calculator. Now 150 is not that good of a number for that wide of an interval, but we got 1.214. That's sort of close to 1.414. Let's crank it up to 200 as we're going to infinity. That gets us to 1.27, getting a little closer, but I use Simpson 200, and now I'm afraid my integral method on my calculator is going to take too long, so I bailed out of that and went to Wolfram Alpha, and got for 500, it's this, for 2,000, it's this, and 10,000, it's 1.3942. which is inching toward 1.414 like it's supposed to. So it's converging, but slowly. Okay, then for p equal 1, you can actually compute that out pretty easy, but using Wolfram Alpha because I got tired of doing it. 2 to 1,000 of 1 over x is, they mean log, natural log when they just say log in Wolfram Alpha. That's 6.21461. And you go to 10,000, it's 8.5. 100,000, it's 10. And it's blowing up, and we know that because the answer to each one of these is natural log of the b over the a. Because remember, the answer was log of b minus log of a, and that's equivalent to this. So you're just dividing this number by 2. So it obviously it's going to just keep on growing forever, creeping to infinity. So here's your recap. P less than 1, the integral diverges to infinity. P equal 1, it also diverges to infinity. P greater than 1 converges, and it converges to this value here.